स्टार्ट सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय नेम इज कमल कुमार एंड टुडे आई विल बी डीलिंग अबाउट द डिटेल डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ ऑप्टिकल फाइबर कम्युनिकेशन, ऑप्टिकल फाइबर कम्युनिकेशन। सो बिफोर गेटिंग ऑन टू द कम्युनिकेशन और हाउ द सिग्नल इज बीन ट्रांसमिटेड यूजिंग दिस ऑप्टिकल फाइबर एंड ऑल, first let us know what is the concept of optics. Optics is a concept which deals with our naked eye. Whatever the thing or the material which can be seen by a human eye, that is a concept determined for an optics. So using that particular concept, as we are dealing with a communication system basically deals with a signal transmission. So a signal is to be transmitted from one source to the other source. So in this communication system, when we are adding our optics concept, the signal which can be seen with our human eye is being transmitted from one position to the other position. So normally this signal is our light source. It may be a laser source or an LED source. So before getting on how the particular block description of an optical communication system, let us see what is the basic communication system which is being used till this particular communication system is being invented. The basic communication system previously was basically used of electrical signals. So in that particular part, the blocks which are used in the communication system are, first is the information source. The first block is our information source, where the basic data or the message or any input signal which is to be transmitted will be in this particular block. Then for this transmission of this particular message, we are adding a transmitter or a modulator. Transmitter, or you can also say it as modulator. So why are we using this particular block? A transmitter block basically enhances the input signal or else boosts up the input signal to transmit for a longer distance. So what is the process happening in a transmitter? The input message signal is being added with a carrier signal. The carrier signal will be of a higher frequency. So when both are being added, the signal will be transmitted for a longer distance, or it can be moved for a longer distance. So here the carrier signal and the input signal is been added. To transmit this signal to the destination side or to the receiver side, we use a communication channel. Communication channel. Right? So the transmitter, the modulated signal of the input source is being transferred with the communication channel. Basically, the communication channel is of a metallic cable or a coaxial cables, which is formed by copper wires. So these wires will be traveling the longer distance from where the information has to be traveled from the input section to the output section. And at the receiver section, before getting on directly to the destination part, first, as we are adding a carrier part in the modulator section, we have to remove the carrier signal first so that the original information will be received at the receiver section. So for removing the carrier signal, we are using a demodulator. Receiver or a demodulator. At this section, the information is being separated with our carrier signal so that the only information is being given to the last destination. This is the general process of the basic communication system which is being done using copper cables and using electrical cables. So first, the information is being taken by this particular device. Then to transmit the information to a longer distance, we are using a process called as modulator, where here the carrier frequency is being added to the information signal so that it can be moved for a longer distance. And to travel the information or to carry the information, we are using a communication channel. This is of basic copper wires. And at the receiver in the demodulator section, we'll be separating the carrier frequency as well as the information source, and at last it is being given to the destination. But why we are shifting from this basic communication system to our optical fiber communication system? So in the communication channel, as we are using copper wires, the bandwidth used by this channel as well as the different disadvantages are very much more. So one of the disadvantages, the bandwidth is very less, so that most of the information cannot be sent at a time, as well as the when if there are any broken cuts or any particular damages in the wires, then the surrounding areas will be getting affected. For example, if this wire is being placed in a hazardous area, the area is being covered with a poison fuel type of gases. Then, if there are any broken cuts in the copper wires, then the short circuit done by this copper wire will cause a damage to that particular area. That is one of the other important disadvantage by this particular communication system. So, keeping all these disadvantages, we are making sure that particular transmission of the signal should be very fast, it should cover a larger bandwidth, and also the errors should be very less, so that we are shifting on to a light source. As you already know, the light speed is approximately 3 to 10 power 8 meters per second, so it is very, very much faster. So we are converting the information signal into a light source, and we are using a form of optical fiber cable where only the light is being transmitted. So if there are any broken cuts, one thing is that we cannot retrieve the information, but we can make sure that in a hazardous area it is much safer compared to the copper wires. When we see the block diagram description of the optical fiber communication, we have the information source at first, so this particular block has our input message, and also we'll be having the same transmitter or the modulator section, because it has to boost up the information signal to the longer distance. The information signal is of an electrical signal, and the transmission device will process the electrical signal that is being added to a carrier signal. But as we are saying, in an optical fiber communication, we have to transfer a light source in a particular cable. So how do we convert this particular transmitter signal into a light source? So for that, we will be using another block. Optical source. So this block main objective is to convert the electric signal into a light signal, so that the light is being transferred to an optical fiber cable. Right? So the first two blocks deals with the electrical signal, whereas for transferring a light signal in that particular cable, we are converting electrical signal into an optical signal. That is being done by the optical source. So a light is being traveled in this particular cable, and at the receiver section also, most of the processing of the signal is being done, or the devices which is being used are of electrical based. So the first part is to convert the optical signal into an electrical signal. So for that, we'll be using an optical detector. The light is being detected from by this device, and it converts the light signal into the respective electric signal. And at the last, it is being given to the demodulator section, where the message signal is being separated from the carrier signal, and at last, it is being given to a destination. Right. So these are the small changes in the optical fiber communication system block diagram as well as the basic communication system block diagram. So we have the information source as well as the transmitter as usual, because most of the processing of the signal is being done in an electrical systems. So we will be not changing those two blocks, but only for the communication part we are using a light source. So we are converting the electrical system into a light signal using an optical source and being given to an optical fiber link. And similarly at the receiver section also, as you already know that the processing is being done electrically, so the first part is to convert the light signal into an electrical signal. That is being done by the optical detector. So when you take the examples of this particular optical source and optical detector, so here we have examples of a laser and an LED. These are the two devices where the electrical signal is being converted into a light signal. Coming to the optical detector, we have photodiodes, phototransistors, as well as photoconductors. These are all the devices which are used for the optical fiber communication. So, as you already said, we have some disadvantages in the communication channel which has been used in the copper wires. So, what are the advantages of this particular optical communication compared to the basic communication system? So, here as you are using a light source, the first advantage is the speed of the transfer of signal is very much high, because as you already know, the light is of 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second. The speed is very much fast. And coming to the second advantage, the second advantage is the bandwidth used for this particular communication is very high. That is, this particular transmission channel can transmit approximately the frequency of 10 power 13 to 10 power 14 megahertz. Whereas when we see the basic communication channel, the transmission of the frequency is around 500 to 1000 megahertz. That is the large difference between a basic communication system as well as the optical fiber communications. So, as the bandwidth is very large, we can transmit the various number of messages at a particular instant. And third most important advantage is, so as per the disadvantage of the basic communication system, as I have said, in the hazardous area, when there is a small split or a broken edge in the cable, it forms a short circuit or a fire in that particular area. But when we have a small cut or a broken part in this particular cable, that here, as it is of a light source, it cannot have a particular short circuiting or a fire producing nature in this particular system. So that these particular communication system can be used in the hazardous areas also. So that is one of the most important advantage compared to the basic communication channel. And coming to the next advantage, the size of this particular optical cable is very less. It is approximately of a thin human hair. The size of the optical fiber is approximately of a human hair, so that this particular cable can be used as extensively as possible. Right? So those are the main advantages why we are shifting from a basic communication channel to a optical fiber communication channel. So as you are seeing, this particular block diagram describes about an analog transmission. So when you see the digital transmission here, it'll be using an encoder.
Sir,
the information signal is of a digital format